I am Dr. Milan Chak. I am international cardiologist at SIMS Hospital, that is Care Institute of Medical Science, Ahmedabad, which is a multi-super specialty hospital at Gujarat, Ahmedabad.
I am Dr. Dhiren Shah, consultant cardiac surgeon, SIMS Hospital, Ahmedabad. Recently at SIMS Hospital, we did a first-time procedure in India that is called TAVR, trans-aortic, transcatheter aortic wall replacement.
Although TAVR is being done in India since last 2 years, but all the TAVR so far done were through femoral arteries. This was the first time that we approached through aorta directly, and the procedure was successful. See, transcatheter aortic wall replacement, what we call TAVR, was initially tried for the first time maybe in 2002. So almost is a story of almost 13 years now. Was done by Dr. Alain Cribier in France initially for the first time in world. And since then, the technique has evolved to a great extent. And now it is officially recommended by American College of Cardiology and European Society of Cardiology for a group of patients who are extremely sick for aortic wall replacement. Surgery is the standard treatment for that. But when patient is at very high risk, means there are two types of patients. Those who are inoperable, means surgical risk is so high that surgeons are not ready to take the patient for surgery. So that is the one group of patients for which it was studied, and it is proven that it is clearly superior to medical therapy. And the another group is very high risk group of patients where STS score is 6 or more. There also this is a now proven type of treatment, and these are the two groups of patients for which at present this therapy is internationally recommended.
The patient that we operated was an 81-year-old gentleman. He had aortic wall stenosis, which is one of the main wall connecting the heart to the main artery, aorta. That was stenosed, that has become very small. Because of that, the heart has to function very hard. And because of its long-standing duration, the heart had become weak. His ejection fraction has gone down to just 25%. In plain word, we can say that his pumping was just 25%. Along with that, this patient also had kidney disease. Then he had COPD, that is the lungs were bad because of heavy smoking. And along with that, also he had the blockages in all the arteries of the body. This surgery is basically performed on a beating heart surgery without stopping the heart and without taking the patient on heart-lung machine, which reduces a lot of problems or morbidity to the patient. The procedure is in a very simple way. A guide wire is passed through a stenosed or blocked valve. A balloon is passed through that. A balloon is inflated so that the valve becomes open or it is opened up. And in that opened valve, another stent mounted valve is implanted in that position. So this becomes a very simplified procedure, and the patient can be discharged in another 2 days, and overall risk factor is reduced significantly in these patients.
So basically it is relatively low risk procedure. Of course there are risks. Commonest complication is some kind of stroke during inflation of balloon or inflation of stent. Sometimes this calcium debris can go and can reach to the brain and can cause some kind of minor or major stroke. That incidence is around 2-3%. But apart from that, local site complications sometimes can occur, some hematoma and all that, blood collection at the site of puncture. But otherwise, this procedure is relatively safe, has low complication rate, and now 5-year follow-up is also available, where results are very good, comparable to standard surgical therapy.
So I would say the take-home message is that this is a fantastic technology that can be used in a very high-risk category of patients and give them a good quality of life for long.